Thank you. Marion Presbyterian Church for our Christmas Vespers service tonight. After almost 30 years, this church decided it's time for new robes. We have new robes for the choir tonight, just in time for Vespers. Is it hard to believe that it's Christmas time again? Some of you are thinking, amen. So much has happened over the course of the last year. We have experienced great joys and tragic losses. Throughout it all, God has remained faithful to each and every one of us. Christmas time has a way of reminding us that we are never alone, never abandoned, always loved, and always cared for. May we enter this space tonight, this time of worship, with our hearts and minds set upon the wonderful Counselor, the Prince of Peace, God with us.
time when every heart, special rapture fills, each soul becomes a Bethlehem among Judean hills. And Jesus Christ, the Son of God, in his own lowly way, comes seeking room in human hearts to share the Christmas day. May he not find the crowd again, too full for him again, or Christmas gifts and Christmas trees without the Christ of men. But may there be the humble heart with room prepared and blessed, and hearts reborn to greet anew the long-expected guest. At Christmas, when he seeks his place, supreme in human wills, each heart becomes a Bethlehem among Judean hills.
in the air. There's a star in the sky. There's a mother's deep prayer and a baby's low cry. And the star ranges fire while the beautiful sing. The manger of Bethlehem cradles a king. There's a tumult of joy over the wonderful birth. The virgin sweet boy is the Lord of the earth. Ah, the star ranges fire and the beautiful sing. For the manger of Bethlehem cradles a king. In the light of that star lay the ages in peril, and that song from afar has swept over the world. Every hearth is aflame, and the beautiful sing in the homes of the nations that Jesus is King. We rejoice in the light, and we echo the song that comes down from the night, from the heavenly throne. Ah, oh, we shout for the loving evangel they bring, and we greet in his cradle our Savior and King.
of his reborn Son. It must have lit all heaven with praise to see what the heavenly Father had done. The angels joined their voices with the heavenly throng until their laughter filled the air with joy and jubilant song. And those on earth in one small realm could only guess the joy as Mary and Joseph held the hand of God's redeeming glory. We too can join the celestial chorus as that began so long ago, as we embrace the Father's Son sent from heaven to earth below.
Thank you.
born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the time when Herod was king. Soon afterward, some men who studied the stars came from the east to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the baby born to be the king of the Jews? We saw his star when it came up in the east, and we have come to worship him." When King Herod heard about this, he was very upset, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem. He called together all the chief priests and the teachers of the law and asked them, "Where will this Messiah be born?" "In the town of Bethlehem, in Judea," they answered. "For this is what the prophet wrote, 'Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, you are by no means the least of the leading cities of Judah. For from you will come a leader who will guide my people Israel.'" So Herod called the visitors from the east to a secret meeting and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem with these instructions: "Go and make a careful search for the child. And when you find him, let me know so that I too may go and worship him." And so they left. And on their way, they saw the same star they had seen in the east. When they saw it, how happy they were. What joy was theirs. It went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. They went into the house, and when they saw that the child was with his mother, they knelt down and worshipped him. They brought out their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and presented them to him. Then they returned to their country by another road, since God had warned them in a dream not to go back to Herod.
Peace to Mary and Joseph that this was the holy night and the child was indeed the Prince of Peace.
Time, a spectacular thing occurred. God became man. Divinity arrived. Heaven opened herself and placed her most precious one in a human womb. The Omnipotent, in one instant, in flesh and blood. The one who was larger than the universe became a microscopic embryo. And he who sustains the world chose to be dependent upon the nourishment of a young girl. God had come near. He came not as a flash of light or as an unapproachable conqueror, but as one whose first cries were heard by a peasant girl and a sleepy carpenter. Mary and Joseph were anything but royal, yet heaven entrusted its greatest treasure to these simple parents. It began in a manger, these momentous moments in time. He looked anything but a king, his face prunish and red, his cry still the helpless and piercing cry of a dependent baby. Majesty in the midst of the mundane, holiness in the filth of sheep manure and sweat. This baby had overseen the universe. These rags keeping him warm were the robes of eternity. His golden throne room had been abandoned in favor of a dirty sheep pen. And worshiping angels had been replaced with kind but bewildered shepherds. Curious, this throne room. No tapestries covering the windows. No velvet garments in the courtiers. No golden scepter or glittering crown. Curious the sounds in the court. Cows munching, hooves crunching, a mother humming, a baby nursing. It could have begun anywhere. The story of the king. Yet curiously, it began in the manger. Step into the doorway. Peek through the windows. He is here.
Thank you.
us who gather in Bethlehem on this night are not the star seekers. We have not traveled our dreams month after month and year after year, poring over predictions and promises. Most of us sit on our hillsides, tending our sheep. Business as usual. Oh, we've heard rumors of stars, but we don't really give ourselves to seeking. After all, there's more than enough to do in the daily tending. We're simply not on the lookout for stars, nor expecting any light in our darkness. I suppose the important thing is, in the light of the glory of the Lord, to recognize the voice of an angel, and to get up, and in spite of our sheep, to go even unto Bethlehem, to see this thing that is happening.
sing, ye Christmas angels. Christ the Lord is born today, born to bring us full salvation, born to take our sins away. Shine, O shine in all thy glory. Shine, O star in Bethlehem sky. Christ the Lord is born in Mary, born that men no more shall die. Sing, O sing, ye little children. Christ is come, a tiny child. And in Bethlehem's straw-filled manger, Mary cradles Jesus mild. Sing, O sing, ye men and women, while with the shepherds bend your knee. Bring your hearts and love and praises, Christ the Lord of life shall be. Sing, O sing then, all ye people, welcome Christ within your heart. May he keep you in his mercy, and his peace and joy impart. May his blessings crown our labors, keep us in his courts always. So we'll sing with men and angels, Christ the Lord is born today.
Many years ago in a stable in Bethlehem, promises made by God were kept in the birth of Jesus Christ. God still keeps his promises today. He is with you even tonight. May you experience the grace of the God who comes near this Christmas season. Merry Christmas.